Hey, I'm Madhura Vaidya and my roll number is 2015-BID-003. So now, let's discuss about MACA and PAMAS protocol. For learning these protocols, first you should get to know MAC protocols, which are the protocols for ad hoc network. So ad hoc wireless network is a collection of two or more devices equipped with wireless communications and networking capability. Such devices can communicate with another node that is immediately within their radio range or one that is outside their radio range using an intermediate node to relay or forward a network from source to destination. Going to the deep into MAC layer, there is a need to see expanded data link layer. So expanded data link layer is divided into two parts, logical link control and multiple access control. Logical link layer is responsible for flow control and error control, and MAC layer is responsible for medium control. MAC protocol is a set of rules or procedures to allow efficient use of a shared medium such as wireless. Here now consider a network with nodes A, B and C. In this network, a situation may happen like when A and C nodes send information to node B simultaneously, it results in collision of data at node B. This is called as hidden terminal problem. To overcome this collision, all the receiver's neighboring nodes need to be informed that channel will be occupied, and this is achieved using handshake protocol. An RTS, that is request to send message, is sent by node 1 to indicate that it is willing to send data. Then node 2 has allowed this transmission by sending a grant using CTS, that is clear to send message, to node 1 and as well as to node 3. So for some time node 3 will be idle and won't transmit any RTS to node 2, and similarly for node 3 and 4. But is this really a perfect solution? It's not, because there will be cases when collision occurs and RTS and CTS are sent by different nodes. Here, node B is granting CTS to RTS sent by A. However, this collides with RTS sent by D at node C. Node D is hidden terminal from node B because node D doesn't receive expected CTS from C and it retransmits the RTS. When A receives CTS, it is not aware of any collision at node C, and hence it proceeds with data transmission to node B. So it collides with a CTS sent by C in response to D's RTS. So take another problem where when multiple CTS messages are granted to different neighboring nodes causing collision. Here, two nodes are sending RTS message to different nodes at different points in time. A sends RTS to B when B is returning CTS back to node A, and C sends RTS to B. Because C can't hear the CTS sent by B while it is transmitting RTS to D, node C is unaware of communication between A and B, so D proceeds to grant CTS to node C. Since A and C both have granted transmission, a collision will occur when both start sending the data. So this is all about hidden terminal problem and its collisions and handshake mechanism. So next one is exposed terminal problem, which occurs due to overhearing a data transmission from neighboring nodes. Here C is transmitting data to D, but B overhears this data and B gets blocked. And see, although B wants to send data to A, it can't send data to A because it has been blocked due to overhearing. Here in this example, A starts sending data to B, and C senses carrier finds a medium in use and has to wait for A to send data to B. D is outside of range of A, so waiting is not necessary, and here A and C are exposed terminals. So these are all about exposed terminal protocol. So let's get to know what MACA protocol is. So MACA is multiple access with collision avoidance. MACA was originally suggested by Phil Kahn to create usable ad hoc and single frequency network. It resolves hidden terminal and exposed terminal problem. It can also perform per packet transmitter power control, which increases carrying capacity of packet radio. It is a sender initiated protocol because if any node wants to transmit data, it first transmits RTS frame. And here, as you can see, sender sends RTS first and receiver, if ready to receive packet, sends CTS. Once receiver receives CTS, it starts transmitting data. And if by chance packet transmitted by sender is lost, then exponential backoff algorithm is used to back off a random interval of time before retrying. But it might starve flow sometimes, and this problem is solved by MACAW, which is MACA for wireless network. Here there are no carrier sensing in MACA, so collision occurs during RTS and CTS phase. Each mobile host adds a random amount of time to minimum interval required to wait after overhearing RTS or CTS control message. If more than one station transmits RTS concurrently, then it results in collision. And these stations will wait for randomly chosen interval and try again, doubling the average interval for every attempt. The station that wins this competition will receive a CTS from responder and blocks other stations to allow data communication session to proceed. Compared to CSMA, MACA reduces the chances of data packet collisions, since the control message RTS and CTS are much smaller in size compared to data packets, chances of collision are very smaller. So this is all about MACA protocol. So let's move towards PAMAS, which is Power Aware Multi-Access Protocol with Signaling, and it is used to resolve exposed terminal problem. In MACA, there was only one channel to send control signal as well as data, but here in PAMAS, there are two channels, signaling channel to transmit RTS and CTS and data channel to transmit data. PAMAS conserves the battery power by selectively powering off nodes that are not actively transmitting or receiving packets. Here, nodes are required to shut themselves off if they are overhearing other transmissions not directed to them. Here, each node makes an independent decision whether to power off its transceiver or not. There are two conditions that force a node to power off. First condition is, if a node has no packets to transmit, then it should power off if one of its neighboring nodes is transmitting. And if node has packets to transmit, but at least one of its neighboring nodes is transmitting and another is receiving, then it should power off its transceiver. So this is all about the structure of PAMAS. Here it consists of signaling channel interface and data channel interface. The signaling channel interface is used to transmit CTS and RTS signal, and data channel interface is used to send data. Here power aware logic is like a control unit which is used to decide whether power should be on or off. Here, probing is used to detect when node should appropriately power up. The duration of power off is critical since it affects the delay and throughput performance. One thing to remember in PAMAS is that a node can selectively power down only its data interface and leave the signaling interface as power on. So, this is all about the PAMAS and MACA protocol. Thank you.